Hi my dear friends, in this video I am going to tell you a very simple mnemonic with the help of which you can easily remember all the contents of the clavipectoral fascia, all the contents, or we can say all the structures which passes through the clavipectoral fascia. So as the name suggests, clavipectoral fascia. So clavi means this fascia is attached to the clavicle, this fascia is attached to the clavicle, and this fascia is present below the pectoralis major muscle. This fascia is present below the pectoralis major muscle. So one point is that this fascia is attached to the clavicle and this fascia is present below the pectoralis major muscle. So if we will remove this pectoralis major muscle, so we will get this clavipectoral fascia. So this is the clavipectoral fascia, and these are the structures which passes through the clavipectoral fascia. Now what I am doing, I am taking this vertical section from here, so I will get these structures. So anteriorly, this is the pectoralis major muscle, this is the pectoralis minor muscle, behind the pectoralis major muscle, this is the pectoralis minor muscle, and this is the clavicle. This is what clavicle, and this is the clavipectoral fascia. This is the clavipectoral fascia, and the upper part of the clavipectoral fascia splits into two parts, two lamini. One is anterior and one is posterior, and in between these two lamini there is a muscle that is attached to the clavicle. That is why it is called as the subclavius muscle. Now the lower part of the clavipectoral fascia splits again into two lamini, one anterior and one posterior, and this, and within these two lamini there is what, pectoralis minor muscle. Now this fascia is, these two lamini joins together and they continue as again the clavipectoral fascia, and this is in the lower part, this is attached to the axillary fascia. This is the axillary fascia. So the dome shape of the axillary fascia here is maintained by this clavipectoral fascia. As this clavipectoral is, this part of the clavipectoral fascia pulls this axillary fascia, so this dome shaped is maintained by the clavipectoral fascia. The dome shape of the axillary fascia is maintained by the clavipectoral fascia. So this is the thoracoacromial artery that is passing through this clavipectoral fascia. This is what, thoracoacromial artery, and this is the cephalic vein. This is the cephalic vein that is coming inside the clavipectoral fascia, and these are the lymphatics that are coming from the apical group of axillary lymph nodes. These are the apical group of axillary lymph nodes, apical lymph nodes. So these are what, lymphatics. These are the lymphatics coming from the apical lymph nodes, and this is what, this is the lateral pectoral nerve that is innervating the pectoralis major muscle also to the pectoralis minor muscle. Now this part of the cut section can be shown here. So this is clavicle, this is pectoralis major muscle, this is pectoralis minor muscle, this is the clavipectoral fascia, this is the axillary fascia, and in the clavipectoral fascia there are two muscles. One is the subclavius muscle and the second one is the pectoralis minor muscle. So this is very, very important question, that in the clavipectoral fascia, which are the muscles present? So one is the subclavius muscle and second one is the pectoralis minor muscle. And this is the anterior lamina and this is the posterior lamina. The posterior lamina continues as the investing layer of the deep cervical fascia. Now friends, the mnemonic we have CLTL. This is very simple mnemonic. Just write clavipectoral. So from the clavipectoral, just take CL from the clavipectoral and also T and L from the clavipectoral fascia. So CLTL. So what is the mnemonic for the clavipectoral? So from the clavipectoral, you can easily derive the mnemonic, that is the CLTL. What? CLTL. 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 CLTL from the clavipectoral. So from this C, it is cephalic vein. From the L, it is lateral pectoral nerve. From T, it is thoracoacromial artery. And from the L, it is lymphatics. And lymphatics from the apical group of lymph nodes. Lymphatics going to the apical group of lymph nodes from the breast part. From the breast. So clavipectoral word itself will tell you that please derive CLTL from me. What word? Clavi CLTL from me. So friends, this is all about the mnemonic to remember the contents of the clavipectoral fascia. I hope this video is very helpful for you in remembering all these contents. If you really get something from this video, then please share this video as much as possible to your needy friends. And in the last, thanks for watching this video and I wish you all the best for your bright future.